to pack myself up and get out of here. It's already past 6. I had real trouble getting up this morning. Really nice to sleep in a real bed. When I got up, though, I went to the washroom and this ginormous spider came rushing out of the washroom. And it's funny how I don't care when I'm going out to camp out. I'm not worried about the animals or the bugs or the critters. Well, I probably am a little bit, but somehow it's just 10 times worse when it's inside where they're not supposed to be. But anyways, so after the last couple of days of battling heat exhaustion or heat stroke or whatever it was, I'm actually really afraid to hit the road today. And I don't even have food because I haven't been able to resupply because of Yom Kippur. I have water, fortunately. I was able to fill up on water here, so that's good. And I just have to hope that I can find a place where I can buy some supplies along the way. And I've at least I've been able to power up my phone and my power bank, so that's good. But I'm running out of memory space on my phone and I can't change the SD card. Anyways, hopefully I'll get to a place where I will find something that I can use that will actually work to open up my SD card slot so that I can change it and keep doing videos. All right, so those mesh coverings that we saw yesterday covering the agricultural grounds, that's what they look like up close. And these are, I'm assuming they're date palms. You can see the fruit is covered in those, some kind of silver wrapping, I assume, to avoid pests and stuff. And the mesh covering, I guess it gives it a little bit of shade and avoids using that much water, maybe. That would be my guess. Could be wrong, but that is what I'm going to assume. So they go on for quite a ways. So my Shvil marker goes that way. That cow is standing in my way. Guess I gotta go around. I really have to be judicious about my use of video right now because of my hard drive space, but thought I'd show you. There's some more cactus. I think these are the sabras, which Israelis are named after. And I don't know if you can see off in the distance, it actually doesn't, it is much closer than what it looks, is the Mediterranean Sea. All along this route, if I just stop for a second to look up, I just have to look over to my right a little bit and there's the Mediterranean Sea. I just can't get there for a dip. Drat! I'll try to get a better picture for you. Some of you may be wondering why I haven't given you much footage from the actual trail, me walking down the trail. Well, here's another example of exactly why. I am off trail again. I do not know where the trail goes. I spend an awful lot of time looking for trail markers. And I'm probably about four or five meters from the trail. I have no idea where it is. I know it's over that direction, but I can't see any markers and I didn't see where I left off the trail. So that is why you have not had footage of me walking the trail. That is Haifa and Mount Carmel in the distance on the seas of, on the shores of the Mediterranean Sea. So I got off to a start about 7 o'clock, just after 7 o'clock this morning, which is pretty good for me, but not good enough for the Shvil. So I really still have to work on that, but it's probably about 10:30 now. I've been sitting at this nature reserve for the last, I don't know, 20 to 30 minutes, just kind of chilling. It's a lovely place. The groundskeepers and their chainsaw buzzing behind me kind of breaks the ambiance, but But it's been really nice to sit here in the shade and just take a bit of a break. So I've hiked about 3 hours today, and for a total of about 5 kilometers, which is really not particularly good, but the terrain is really rough. And then between also wasting time and energy again, looking for Shvil markers and getting lost, and then, like I said, on the terrain, it's, I don't know, somehow people are able to do 20 and 30 kilometers. I can't. So you're going to get bits and pieces of the Shvil from me, unfortunately. But this spot is the Nahal Me'arot, which is the basically the stream of the caves. And there's some prehistoric caves here, and I'm just contemplating whether I should get up and go check them out while I chill here. And it's a little bit early to be taking a heat break, but after the last couple days, I'm just taking it easy and not taking any unnecessary risks. I won't be doing any more than about 8 kilometers today, and I really desperately need a rest day. So just contemplating what I'm gonna do for tonight, so that I can work in a rest day for tomorrow, and figuring out where the next best section of the Shvil would be to hike. So I will get back to you on all that. All right, I said I didn't want to do any climbing today, but here I am climbing up to the caves, which apparently are supposed to be very interesting, so, and taking a selfie with the funky caveman sculptures. This is absolutely crazy, unbelievable. So it's a cave, and they've done archaeological digs in there. There's all kinds of evidence of, like, human habitation in prehistoric times. And I just can't even begin to tell you everything about it, because it's just way too complex for me. But it's so interesting. Totally worth a visit if you're anywhere in the area, if you're doing the Shvil, or if you just happen to be in Israel in sort of the northern coastal area, south of Haifa, and it's called the Nahal Me'arot. It's kind of across from, a little bit south of Atlit. So definitely recommend it. It's just, this is the first cave. I haven't even seen the other caves yet. And this one says, do not linger at the entrance to the cave due to risk of rock slide. Okay. This one's not quite as elaborate as that other one, but they've put some statues or models of people in here to kind of illustrate what it would have been like back in the day. And that is just crazy. Even actually what seems to be like rooms or storage places of some sort that have been hewn out of the rock. Wow, this is unbelievable. Just unbelievable. Apparently people would have lived in caves like this, and this one has evidence, along with the others, evidence of human habitation, prehistoric habitation. It's just unbelievable. There's a short movie every half hour. The narration, such as there was in Hebrew with no subtitles, so would love it if they would change that so you could understand what they're saying. But for the, it kind of reimagines the life of the people who would have lived here. And that part is not narrated and doesn't really need narration. It's quite interesting and fairly well done. They've also found signs of life here outside the caves. So that's that big cave that I was just in with the movie. And outside on the, there's a, like a man-made terrace and burial. You can see the burial, right, the reconstruction of a burial right there. And some kind of strange round circle holes that they haven't been able to figure out what the use was for. They figure it's probably something related to the burials, so very, very fascinating and totally, I would say, worth a visit if you're ever in the area. Again, Nahal Me'arot Caves. And it also looks like there's ongoing archaeological excavations. I assume that's what that sort of temporary shelter is for. So, wow, this is just incredible. So I just hitched a ride from Nahal Me'arot, where I toured those caves, to Beit Hanania, which is probably about 20 kilometers further down the highway. And I'm so happy to see a Shvil marker again. So this is where I'm going to rejoin the Shvil, to get to a little Arab village on the Mediterranean Sea, which is where I'm going to stay tonight. Holy smokes! So here I am, just about to take off from Beit Hanania, and I was just about to walk right by this, but right behind me is the beginnings of a Roman aqueduct that just goes all the way there, and we're going to see more of these over the next today and tomorrow. Actually, maybe not tomorrow, but over the next couple days. Because we're just approaching Caesarea, otherwise known as Caesarea, or Caesarea by the Sea, I think, or something, which is amazing, amazing ruins of a city built by Herod for the Caesar Augustus in the first century, I believe. So I am absolutely floored and stunned. I've never seen these ruins before, and I just about walked right by them. Wow, crap. I don't know if you can see them that well because of the sun shining behind me, but these are absolutely stunning. And these aren't even even close to the best ruins that we're about to see over the next couple days. This is just amazing. And it's just here, plunked in the middle of, you know, on the edge of town of Beit Hanania. Incredible. I guess somebody just decided to leave a column underneath the aqueduct for I don't know what reason. And you can see the Shvil marker right there. The Shvil just casually goes under the aqueduct. Unbelievable. This is why I love the Shvil. Well, that and a lot of other reasons too, but I'm just speechless. Absolutely. You can see it starts way over there, goes way back over here, turns around the corner where I came from. I'm just speechless. This is unbelievable. And then people just, the town of Beit Hanania, people just have their houses across the street. This is unbelievable. I love it. Amazing. It just goes on and on and on. There's a little break here. Not sure why that is, but it continues over there. But I just came from way over there. Sorry, way over there somewhere. And it just keeps going. Like, it's behind me here, and then it's over there. Unbelievable. I came from, yeah, over there. Crazy. Yeah, it just keeps going and going. I just wonder, keep walking along here and, oh, more cows. They're everywhere here. I keep wondering about the engineering and the manpower and the work that would have had to go into building this, like, monumental aqueduct back in the day, like 2,000 years ago. I'm just amazed. And I don't know what those would have been for, those little niches. If people would have had stalls, or I don't know, might have been an idea. have stalls and shops and stuff in there. Who knows? And I don't know if you can see it, but right behind me, right there, I think, if I'm pointing in the right place, is a Shvil marker. Not sure what good it does over there, but that's quite funny. And another funny thing, there's a river that stops right here, so I get to cross on dry land. I feel kind of like Moshe and the ancient Israelites crossing the parting of the Red Sea. But it doesn't actually continue down there, so I'm sure in the spring season it's probably much higher and continues on. But for now, I get to cross on dry land. Woohoo! And it just keeps going. I turn the corner and it keeps going on and on. It's overgrown here, but it's just beside a farmer's field. That's it. Yeah, we have an ancient Roman aqueduct right along our farmer's field. Great. Unbelievable. I'm in awe. And someone left a chair for my afternoon coffee break under the aqueduct, which just keeps going and going, kind of like the Energizer Bunny. But my Shvil situation is a little weird. There's no markers again. And I'm just walking through some farmer's field along the aqueduct. So, oh well, I'm going in the right direction, so I guess that's what matters. And like just through those bushes there, that arch right there, in the aqueduct, it still even has, I don't know if they're the original, but it has like the wood, can't really probably see it on the video, but it has the wood grates on it. That's insane. And I still don't know if I'm on the Shvil or not. Oh well. Well, I saw a Shvil marker, and where it got me was in the middle of this thorn field. And I'll bet you nobody ever comes through here. Except for me, so why am I doing this? I have no idea. But it smells like licorice. I'll take that. Love that smell. But somehow I have to find my way out of here before I lose space on my phone, on my memory card, and before I get choked alive by all these thorns. Yeah. Well, I'm being choked alive by thorns, but apparently I'm still on the Shvil, because there's the marker. I hope you can see it. But then, these markers, don't know if you can see them there, they're mostly that one over there, suggest that the Shvil comes from there, which would have been a whole lot easier than coming from there, which is where that marker also says it comes from. So, I have no idea. But, apparently I do continue this way, so... nothing comes easy out here. Nothing. So there's the only marker. Can you see that? Oh no. The only marker I've seen, and that's going the wrong direction, for ages, through that whole bramble thorn brush. It's like, this is the last chance, this is your last marker. Enter here and never come out alive again. Jeepers, creepers. And there's no markers. There's no markers throughout there to, like, give you the confidence that you're on the right track. But I'm still with the aqueduct. Unbelievable. For the last... It's actually not that far, but it's taken forever just because it's such difficult brush to get through. And I think here, I don't see the marker again, but I think it actually goes under that arch to the other side, and then there's an underpass under the highway to get me into the village where I'm trying to get to. All right. There's the marker. Where? There. There finally is the marker.
and right there. And somebody's made this into their little chill out spot. I gotta say, it's a really lovely little spot. It's nice and shaded probably most of the day. And I sure wouldn't mind taking a break here, but I'd rather get to my destination. So here we go.
Oh man, there is nothing quite like fresh falafel made right in front of your eyes, right while you wait. I'm sorry, there's only one left. I ate them all. This is so amazing good. And the hummus, not sure what it is about the hummus, but it's like buttery and I don't even know what it tastes like. Like it's, I was gonna say tahini, but it's mostly tahini, but it's not tahini. I mean, obviously it's got tahini in it because it's hummus, but like it just tastes like, I don't know, velvet. I feel so much better with some food in me after all those thorn bushes and brambles. And yeah, so this is a really, really cool place. It's a guest house that they've started as kind of a social project. And maybe I'll try to see if I can get one of the people who work here to tell you more about it before I leave, because I haven't actually had a chance to spend much time in Arab villages because I skipped a lot of that area in northern Israel and where I would have seen Arab villages. So I think I might spend a little time here today and tomorrow. Okay, you're never gonna guess what happened. So I'm at a street party at a moshav called Aviel, which one of the ladies from the guest house where I'm staying took us here. And on the way, this is not the most interesting part, on the way she stopped by her house and to wash her car, and she invited us into the house and actually onto the back patio. So I thought, okay, she's just inviting us to the back, sit on the back patio and wait while she washes her car. And I stepped out on the patio and there were two horses there. I couldn't believe it. So yeah, so two more horses and then a street party. What a strange day. But this is, I guess, par for the course sometimes. Brambles and thorns and bushes to a street party in a moshav. What an up and down crazy day, but I'm staying in this guest house in that bunk bed right there for tonight, and possibly for tomorrow, but probably just for tonight. And tomorrow I'll tell you some more about this place because it's really a fascinating place and fascinating town. And yeah, I can't wait to tell you more about it tomorrow. So till then, Laila Tov.